Now, you've been an NBA player for a long time. How tough is this not to be on it? Now, you're on a different team, but not to be on a basketball team.
You know what? I'm going to be really, really honest. It's not as tough as I thought I would be. Like, it would be. Like, I miss it. I miss the camaraderie. I miss being around the guys. I miss being around the players. But it was time. It's something very, very comforting when you were able to get everything out of your system. Me and my agent were having a conversation not too long ago, and he was like, Richard, you know, 4 years ago, you said you wanted to play one or two more years. And I was like, you know what? You're right. And so, you know, I'm at such peace and ease with just kind of, you know, moving on. And that's, I said that in a message on social media, that I'm kind of moving on from basketball just because I felt like it was time.
But you could still play, I would assume, right?
Yeah, I feel like I can still play. And again, part of, like, you know, even if you're not signed in that initial, you know, free agency rush, there was a lot of interest. There were people that I were talking to. Some things didn't pan out. Some people decided to go a different direction. But you look at injuries, you know, even, you know, Damari Carroll, you know, having ankle surgery, stuff like that. There would have been so many opportunities that present themselves in the first month of the season. But I just felt like there were other things that I wanted to do and accomplish in my life. And basketball was not a part of the 5-year plan anymore. And so I felt like there was opportunities that were presenting themselves that I were more interested in and more excited about, and that's kind of why I decided to take this step.
Was it made easier by the fact that you were able to get a ring a couple years ago?
1,000%. 1,000%. That was really my only goal. I've always, you know, in my entire career, I've always, you know, kind of judged the season by how the team played and how far we went. And a lot of that was based off of, you know, how I played in college and then my first couple of years in New Jersey. So, you know, to win that championship and to get the ultimate goal, that made, you know, I was ready to retire then. I wanted to go out on top, but people kept dragging me back in, and I was like, all right, fine.
Now, is there a lot of pressure, though? Because people look at you, I don't want to put the pressure on you, but you're like a Tony Romo type, that you cannot fail in the broadcast. Like, you were made for this. Do you hear those things, and do you believe that you're made for this?
Well, I'm going to first say this. Like, one, Tony's amazing. Tony Romo's amazing. But there's no pressure that anybody can put on me that I wouldn't put on myself. Like, I approach this with the exact same type of focus that I approach kind of like my rookie year in the league. Like, I want to get here. I want to prove myself. I want to kick ass and take names. And I want to, you know, I want to be the best at this. And, you know, I have, you know, I'm a little bit older. I'm a little more confident now. But, you know, if you're going to do something, and, you know, I've been blessed to get, you know, with the gift of gab, and, you know, for me, it's just like, how can I bring the fans to a more knowledgeable place? How can I entertain the fans and still, you know, make them understand the game at another level? And those are the challenges that I want to face head on, and I want to be the best. And I know, you know, not to be too critical of myself, but that I'll be better in game 5 than I was at game 1, and I'll be better in game 10 than I was in game 5. But my goal is just to get better and better and better, and really just increase the experience for the fans.
All right, let's talk about this Nets team. Slow and steady. I mean, this group, you know, Sean Marks and Atkinson took over. They had no draft picks because of the trade with the Celtics, and now they're finally out from under that. And it seems like, I don't know if this is the year, but they're moving in the right direction. What's your feel?
Well, they've been moving in the right direction. Sean has done a really, really good job of, you know, they've unloaded some contracts. They've acquired some picks. They've gotten back in the mix. Even the D'Angelo Russell, you know, bringing him in basically means that you have the number 2 pick from 3 years ago, right? So, you know, you put yourself in a position where it's like maybe you didn't have a traditional pick, but if you were able to get a high-level pick like Russell, that puts you in a spot where it's like, okay, you know, the future is bright. You're moving in the right direction, and you have to give them all the credit. I do believe that there's obviously more steps to go, but you're finally moving in the right direction. And then for the last like 3 to 4 years, it was very difficult for, you know, fans with, you know, obviously Boston having the success and having all the draft picks and doing all these different things. But I think now that, you know, their game plan is starting to, you can start to see it, and it's starting to, you know, kind of come to fruition. I think this is an exciting time for the Nets and for, you know, the Nets fan base.
I've heard so many things, Richard, from people in the NBA that, you know, Kenny Atkinson is looked at as a big-time star in the coaching industry, and, you know, just what he did with the last year's Nets team. Is he looked at that way by the players around the league?
Yes, and a lot of people, you know, a lot of people kind of look at this situation like, man, this is a tough situation. It takes a very strong-minded and strong-willed and a confident person, even for Sean, to take this job. Like, yeah, you can take any job, but when you take a job where it's like, hey, there's going to be some rebuilding, there's going to be, I don't want to say dark times, but there's going to be some times where it's like, man, this is really, really difficult. And especially when most of the time you have difficult seasons, you're rewarded with a good draft pick. So that just brings the energy back to the franchise. So for them to take the job, especially in this New York media, in the tri-state area, to take on that challenge with all the things that were, you know, kind of put in front of them, is just a compliment to who they are as people, that they are willing to take on these challenges, even though, you know, there might not have been an end in sight when they first took over.
Talk with new Yes Network Nets analyst Richard Jefferson here on the Michael K Show. Let's spread it out a little bit and go around the league. I've always wanted to ask somebody who played with him. You were on a championship team with LeBron. What's it like being his teammate? Is he overly demanding? Is it tough to play with him? Tell me.
No, I wouldn't. Overly demanding is not the right word. I think this is a man that every day he steps on the floor, there's a tremendous amount of pressure on him. And his job is to go out there and make his, to not only win the game, but to make the job easier for his teammates. And so, you know, yeah, there are certain players that love the game, and there are certain players that love the lifestyle of the game. There are certain people that want to score points, and there are some people that want to win games, and there are some people that want to win championships. I think Bron is a person that always has a championship in his sights, and so for any player, if championship isn't your final goal, then yeah, it might be hard because you might not see it. And you know, one of Brahm's favorite quotes is by Jerry West. He's like, winning is the most important thing to me. If it's not the most important thing to you, then you're probably not going to like me. And, you know, that's not for every player. That's not for everybody. But then again, winning championships and winning games, that's not for everyone either.
Do you think he's going to do well this year with the Lakers? Do they have enough this year?
Enough to what?
To, let's say,
50 games.
Conference finals.
Oh, conference finals. Huh?
Stephen A. Smith on before us said he sees them in the conference finals.
Wow.
Yeah, but Stephen A. gets paid to say, like, over-the-top absurd things, right?
Wow.
That's his job. I think if you do that, I think then they overachieved. Many of Bron's teams had overachieved. Everyone talks about his final streak, but when he went back to Cleveland and he signed there, Kyrie was a high level but still a young player. Kevin Love wasn't even there yet. So for them, him to take that team to the finals, and even I think they might have finished second in the conference after Atlanta, and then to lose Kevin and to lose Kyrie. So Bron has a history of overachieving in most seasons that he plays in. But I think 50 games, I think, is attainable. But do I think conference finals? I think there would have to be an upset somewhere in the first round or in the second round. There would have to be an upset. I don't think that they're going to finish in the top. They're not going to finish in the top three. So that would probably mean that they would have to upset somebody in
right.
the second round of the playoffs to get to the conference finals. So I think they're in a very, very good position. It's L.A. You know, L.A. has a home court advantage, unlike other places, because of the nightlife, because of the glitz, because of the glamour. So I think when people go to L.A. now, you know, there's a little bit of a different feel. You got to make sure that you get your rest, which, you know, young players typically don't. So, you know, you're going to get guys that are probably hanging out all night. Because in Cleveland, that was one thing that you had to know. In Cleveland, it was a very calm city. There wasn't a lot going on. It's an amazing town. But the home court advantage was based off the fans, not all of the attractions that might distract players when they got to town.